Do not attempt the training techniques you are about to see without consulting a professional. Tonight on Cesar 911, Cesar takes on three barking Bichons and an owner who just won't cooperate.
They say my dog's not normal, but for me, they're normal. Yeah? I'm about to quit.
They are annoying customers at his restaurant.
They're like little gangbangers.
And infuriating his wife in the bedroom.
I'm gonna cut off the sex.
What?
Then, Cesar comes to the rescue of this 140-pound Labrador. Who's taking over his owner's company and becoming the boss. Cesar Milan is called to the rescue by friends, family, and neighbors whose lives have been turned upside down by dogs in crisis. Using everything in his arsenal, Cesar is answering the call.
I'm getting tan just by watching this.
You never know where Cesar will show up next. On Cesar 911. Cesar's first 911 call is to a dog-friendly diner, where whistleblowers Patty and Lori Joe are fed up with their boss's dogs because they're annoying customers and hurting business.
Hi.
Hi, Cesar.
Nice to meet you. How are you?
Hi, Cesar. It's finally nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
I'm Patty. I am the head server at Frisco's Restaurant Bar and Grill.
Thank you.
The atmosphere at Frisco's, it's fun. It's for families. They're very relaxing. The kids enjoy watching the girls on skates.
My name is Lori Jo Grzowski, and I do some managing here. Here at Frisco's, we have a dog-friendly patio. We call it the Doggy Diner, and I feel that that's one reason that we're so successful.
Okay. Joanne is my sister, and Takis is my brother-in-law.
Takis and Joanne own Frisco's. Takis has got this big, fat, great Greek personality.
Oh, no! Oh, look at that! Oh, my God!
The only downside of our Doggy Diner is when Takis shows up.
What are you pushing, guys? Take it easy.
With his three dogs.
Oh, let's go, let's go. Oh, I gotta go there.
Takis means well, and he loves the dogs to death. But, you know, he feels that, oh, let them be free. Let them express themselves.
They're in America.
Do you see that big Frisco truck right there? He pulls up in that. And then sometimes he leaves them in there if he doesn't bring them up to the patio. But then Monamu gets tired of being in there for a while, and then he honks the horn.
Hey, stop it.
And it's really obnoxious when everybody's
the dog does
eating. We have customers leaving here. We have regulars that say, I'm not coming back until he stops bringing those dogs around.
What he says?
Ah, dog. Forget about it. They'll come back. Don't listen to them.
What are we going to see? And what?
I think I hear them.
Yeah.
I hear them.
You should probably hear they come.
Wait until they arrive and you're really going to see something.
That is the typical bark of dogs who don't have rules, bounds, limitations.
That's them summarized very nicely.
Owners Takis and Joanne have no idea that their employees have called Cesar to help them.
The truth is, normally I surprise people. But when I saw the Muslims coming in, they surprised me because they were absolutely out of control. Oh. Wow.
Oh, my God. I go, oh, my God, that's Cesar Milan. He's here.
But it is.
How are you? I was, like, really excited. I go, oh, my God, that's so neat.
How are you,
sir?
What's up, man? How are you doing?
Give me a hug.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, I appreciate this. We'll give it a hug.
I was very surprised, but nobody can help me, you know?
How are you?
Yeah. I'm fine with my dogs.
I don't know what to say.
Surprise.
They say my dog's not normal, but for me, they're normal.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Yeah, they got a Greek temper.
Oh, that's your
interpretation.
They're Greek dogs.
My wife says I have to fix you before I fix the dog. So I don't know. You think you can fix me? I don't know.
I would love to.
Good luck.
I'm Joanne Frisco Stothelis, and I'm married to Taki Stothelis. We've been married for 33 years, and we have three little Bichons. We call them the Moos. Moo means mine in Greek.
The first one, Manamu, means my mother, my sweet mother. Kuklamu, which means little doll. And the other one is Agorimu, means my boy. Everything's Moose.
But you used to call me Kuklamu, and I lost that title, too,
no
to her.
Yeah, you know more.
My husband thinks Manamu's human, okay? So much so that he had him baptized Greek Orthodox. The reason why we got a second dog was because we thought that, okay, he's going to be 1 year old. Let's get him a wife for his birthday. And so my husband went down to the rescue shelter and found this beautiful little Kukla. After they're married, on their 1 year anniversary, I thought maybe we should rescue another little dog, a little boy, so they have their own little family, the Moos. I really wish my husband would discipline the dogs a little bit more because, not a little bit, a lot more.
Oh, no. Energy.
You think it's energy? It's energy. Really annoying energy. To people. Energy. It's annoying. They're like little gangbangers. I go to bed after he does, usually, because he falls asleep and I'm up for a while. Then when I get into the room, I try to go to bed, and here I have one on my pillow, one next to me, one on the other side. And then my husband, there's absolutely no room for me. I feel like I'm being kicked out. I want to go to sleep, okay?
Okay, get out. Okay.
But especially with Kukla.
What about her?
She comes between us, and she'll put her face on my husband's face and her paw on him and puts her butt to my face. And I can't sleep like that. I really can't.
Come on, girl. Come on. Let's go. Let's go.
Come on. Leave him there. It's okay.
No, I really am at my wit's end here. There's no privacy in this house. There's nothing but chaos. And these dogs are just coming between us, if you know what I mean. You know what I mean. Yes.
Okay.
Is that normal? Look.
No, you be quiet.
I can't hear you, you know that, right? Okay, what I'm saying, people...
How about you stop so I can hear you?
Oh, I can't, that's a problem.
I can't hear anything. So I have to take his dogs away so I can actually hear Taki's talk. So we can have a conversation.
There I am.
Oh my God, look how calm she is.
I don't want a dog like sleeping all day. I want a dog like aggressive.
Your intention is more, I want my dog to look, you know, Greek and represent.
You call much mangas.
You know, I want him to bark at everybody and throw plates.
There you go. Where's the plates? Bring the plates. Bring the plates.
The dogs are doing exactly what the owner wants them to do. I mean, he is absolutely enjoy this chaos.
I mean, it's okay, but all the time, like this,
no,
I'm going to fall asleep.
I don't know. I think I'm about to quit. I was about to walk out. I just didn't see anybody was receptive, you know, to listen to me and to get the help. His wife is desperate. The employees are desperate. But it's nothing we can do if we can't have Takis on board.
I just feel like I'm the other woman in bed, you know?
I am the other woman.
Jesus Christ.
I can show you a different approach.
Me, I think my dog's normal. I'm normal too. But if they think I'm not normal, I will do for her. I promise I will do for you. If you think I'm not normal. You think I'm a normal
person? No, you're not.
How about my dogs?
No.
Okay, I will
Anything
try.
Anything you touch becomes not normal.
You know what? I love you, and I will do it for you.
Thank you.
Okay, what can I say?
Shorten up the leash, that's it. Yeah, this way, my friend.
Okay, thank you. Come on, guys. Whoa.
Come on.
Sorry, guys.
I don't know.
Oh, my God. Sorry,
thank you.
Sorry, guys.
Sorry, everybody.
Cesar Milan has his work cut out for him.
I'm about to quit.
Not only are Takis and Joanne's three Bichons causing chaos at the restaurant.
Come on. Come on.
And at home. But he also has to get Takis to change his ways in dealing with his beloved dogs.
I can show you a different approach.
Cesar tries to get Takis to buy into his methods by demonstrating a calmer way of bringing the dogs into the restaurant.
I'm coming here. I'm you.
Yes.
I'm Greek. I feel good.
You say Opa.
I feel Opa.
There you go.
So here you present, and they have to show that they can behave calmly. It's just different. And they look beautiful.
Always.
Right? Always. But they look calm. So the reaction is going to be different.
The moose go into a frenzy when they see other dogs.
I got to go there.
But it's much easier to keep the moose calm when you enter calm, rather than wild and crazy.
So you still come into the restaurant just in a different way, right? It's much more space on this side, so I choose this side, excuse me. You know, I greet the clients. Thank you for coming. How are you guys? You know, come this way. Let's go. How's the food? Great, awesome, I love it, thank you. And then I come and sit down. And we're just changing calmness versus chaos.
When Cesar took him for a walk on my patio, I said, these aren't my dogs. They're not my dogs. It's impossible. No one's been able to do that with my dogs ever.
They're already sensitive. It's just he provides always that. They can do whatever they want.
But I think you have the touch. It's not everybody has the touch. That's what you do, what you do.
No? My frame of mind is different than your frame of mind. It's not the touch.
I don't know if it's going to work for me. I mean, I was very impressed with Miss Cesar, but I don't think it's going to work for me. I don't know. I will try, but I don't know.
To show Takis that even he can keep the moose calm around other dogs, Cesar takes the couple to meet his personal dogs, Junior and Alfie.
Hey. All right, so let me get here. Guys.
Cesar first stresses the importance of holding the leash in a way that creates calmness.
You're holding leash in front. And that is actually telling them, fight.
Go to war.
Yeah. You could tell by the way I was holding the leash, kept the dog calm because he was beside me. But the way Takis was holding it let the dogs be in front of him, which caused them to brace for a fight. But see, if a big dog grab one of your dog is gonna get hurt. Because your dog is instigating.
What Cesar told me, when my dogs can start a fight and they get hurt, then I open my eyes. I couldn't imagine if my babies they could get hurt.
Leash on the side. We're here. Guys, we're gonna come and meet Mexican dogs.
Cesar shows that by keeping the moose to the side instead of out front and by remaining calm, he can approach bigger dogs without the moose going wild.
So here we close the distance, but this is much safe, friendly. Mexican, Greek.
Oh my God. You put my dogs with a pit bull.
I put my dogs with your dogs.
Well,
that's a dangerous guy.
I know. Oh my God, look at that. They look.
I can't believe it.
It's amazing. I don't know.
Your turn.
Oh my God. when Cesar told me, go ahead, take the dogs and do what I did exactly, I got scared. Sure, I got scared. Because I thought I'm never going to be able to do that.
Tucky, this, no, this, proud Greek. This is not proud Greek.
I know, but I'm scared. That's why I'm...
No, no. Greeks are not scared. They're
Great Alexander. About...
Yeah. Alexander. Yeah, yeah. Come on, just pass
they,
by.
They feel you.
Okay. That's right. Relax the arm. Relax it like... Just pass by. There you go. Come on. Relax the arm. There you go. Now you're here.
Look at that. It's like a miracle. It's like amazing what happened to me. I couldn't believe what happened. I never thought in a million years, and it works for me.
Yeah, Greek Island. I've never been.
Hold the dogs behind me, and I'd be the leader, and they follow me. And I tell them what to do. They don't tell me what to do.
So because you're thinking of, that's right. You're thinking about what you love, your land, your dogs.
Yes,
get that.
Yes. They feel it.
I finally got a breakthrough with Takis. So as the Greeks say, Opa.
And the very next day...
No tense Greek. Calm Greek.
Takis walks his three Bichons onto the deck of his restaurant.
Bravo!
Without his dogs disrupting his customers.
Beautiful.
Something that he was never able to do before.
Look at him.
Very good.
Woo-hoo!
Look at that.
Thank you. I gotta give you a hug, man. You're awesome.
I was nervous. I was scared. But you know what? I won. I followed his instructions. And I think I did it good. I think I passed the test.
Just relax the thing.
I was really proud of you.
Thank you.
Cesar has helped Takis get control over his dogs at his restaurant.
That's beautiful.
Now, he needs to help him at home.
Come on, stop it!
So Cesar invites Takis, his wife Joanne, and their dogs to his 5,000 square foot home training annex.
Come on, guys.
Come on in, guys.
Hi.
You have a restaurant? I have a training annex. This is what I want to prepare people how to be indoors.
Thank you.
A living room to an office to a bedroom to a kitchen. Come on in. Just welcome home. This is your house.
The biggest problem at home for this couple is in the bedroom.
Let's go night night.
This is where we're going to practice.
Because of their dogs, Joanne is either not sleeping or not getting any alone time with her husband.
I'm just so happy that we're here today so we finally can get peace and quiet and I can get my bed back.
So the challenge, the moose will stay here on the bed, nice and comfortable, and you guys stay in the human bed. You should be able to tell your dogs, night-night, you know, let's go to sleep. And the dog just completely settled down. So this is all your beds from home, right? This is all your stuff. So you're making it familiar to them. But this is really good. Just for them to stay right there. That's the only challenge we're doing right now. So bring her back in here.
Kukla.
Kukla!
Back in your place now.
You can help them.
Come on, Kukla, let's go.
Back in your place.
She's dying right now.
I know.
Kukla, I'm divorcing you tonight. That's it. Over there. Stay there.
Don't look back.
Don't look at him. Just do the exercise.
Stay there, all of you. Don't you move from the bed.
It's on the back. Hey, go. Up.
No.
Madam.
Let's go. Back in your place. Come on, back in your place.
Don't do that. What are you doing? I can't believe this guy. You know, he's following my directions, but 30 seconds later, he goes right back to his old habits. I can see how Joanne is also becoming frustrated.
Get back to bed. Back to your bed. You're not helping the situation, you know?
I married you, not the dogs. They have to go in their own bed, okay?
They don't want
to
go.
Pick them up, put them in their beds, and be more aggressive.
Tell them to go to bed.
Go to your bed.
You have to mean it.
Go to your bed now.
Stop laughing. I'm really serious.
I'm going to cut off the sex.
At Caesar's home training annex, Takis has reverted back to enabling his three Bichons.
Come on, back to your place.
Don't do that. What are you doing?
And they're taking over the bed. Takis' wife, Joanne, has finally had enough.
I'm going to cut off the sex. Seriously.
What?
No, I'm serious. That's it. I'm cutting
really?
You off. That's right.
You're going to cut. Okay, guys, you know what?
That's
back
it.
At your place now. I'm going to take care of business. I got a problem now. You go back at your place. Come here. After so many years, come on, buddy. Come here. Ouch, 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 ouch.
It's funny how guys can change as long as the motivation is there.
Don't bite. Your mother's going to bite me now. I know that. Good boy, good girl. Stay back there. Kukla! You know Kukla? You make me mad now. You go back to your place. I can't do it. I can't do it. You know what, Kukla?
Yeah.
I'm not doing my job.
Oh, that's awesome.
I'm not doing my job. You understand that?
So at one point, accidentally, he said a word, you know what?
You know what?
And I saw a completely change from him and from the dogs.
There you go. Okay, that's it.
Wow.
That's it. Very, very important moment.
One time I say something, you know what? Or you go back to your place, or but my voice is stronger. Like I'm the boss now. Okay?
Voila.
Opa. Because of you. Caesar told me, he says, you know what? You got something you created, but you never used that tool. You know what? There you go. Okay, that's it. And I want you to use that tool. And that's what I do.
Wow.
Look at that. Never happened this.
Are
you happy?
I'm happy.
Let's go, baby.
Let's
go, Spooner, baby. Let's go. Let's go, Spooner.
I think I'll be able to get a good night's sleep now and not have, like, three dogs jumping on me and coming between us and try to take all his attention. And I'm looking forward to that.
Okay, turn the cameras off, okay?
I'm gonna step out.
Thanks, okay. Thanks for this. Thank you.
Night, night. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you.
Good night.
But will Takis' success continue after Caesar leaves? To find out, Caesar puts up surveillance cameras to monitor his progress for the next week. Can Takis keep his dogs from bothering his customers and his wife when Caesar's not around? Only these cameras will reveal the truth. For Caesar's next 911 call, he heads to the Freedom Riders Foundation to meet with Tiffany and Sue Ellen, whose workplace is being disrupted by their boss's dog, Bo.
Yes!
Freedom Riders Foundation.
My name is Tiffany Jacobs, and I am a Freedom Rider coordinator. My name is Sue Ellen Alpizar. I am the HR person at the foundation.
The Freedom Riders were started 17 years ago by Miss Gruel, also known as Miss G. She took a bunch of at-risk kids and pushed them to write about their hardships. The program transformed the lives of hundreds of students, then caught the eye of Hollywood, resulting in the movie Freedom Riders, starring Hilary Swank.
I have been through so much, and I can honestly say that the one constant in my life has been Miss G since I met her.
This is, it looks like a home, but it's all offices in each
really?
One. Yeah.
In front of the beach?
Yeah,
in front of the beach. You can't get any better than
that. Yeah, I thought so. I had a nice office.
What's the deal?
Well, we have a dog here, Bo, which is Miss G's dog, but is also our dog in
Miss
a way,
G.
too. Miss G is Miss Gruel, our teacher.
And she was our English teacher in high school, and we've been with her all these years later.
Yeah, practically.
Practically, yeah. Yes. Bo is a 140-pound Labrador, and he just disrupts the office quite a bit. 140 pounds.
Bo is constantly barking.
His bark is so ferocious. It's nearly impossible to sit there and have a conversation.
Bo, no.
Bo is always wreaking havoc, whether it's bringing in a dead animal to the meeting.
He snatches people's food right out of their hands. We are always on bow watch, and we want him to be here, you know, but a lot of times it's like, boo, boo, you have 10 people saying, no, boo.
He's also so big and
lazy.
Yeah, and lazy.
He does not want to go. Come on.
There you go, boo.
Come on, boo.
If she's a little overweight, he's going to become lazy.
Yeah, it takes 3 people to get him in a car.
It's difficult because of his sheer size, and his determination is quite huge.
Oh no, oh no, oh no! No, Bo, stay inside.
He has something against sweatshirts
or
too,
hoodies.
Or hoodies.
Sometimes Bo profiles people. If I'm walking him and he sees somebody with a hoodie, he will lunge at them.
Bo, no, Bo, no, Bo.
You literally have to use all your strength to kind of pull him back.
Miss G, she's gotten hurt before. She almost got her shoulder dislocated.
He dragged her down?
Dragged her down, yeah. He really doesn't understand who's the boss.
He is the boss.
He is the boss, exactly.
And actually, that's his official, unofficial title.
Yeah.
Is the CEO.
If Bo doesn't get help now, it's only a matter of time before someone gets hurt. He's just so big and powerful, and we won't be able to get work done and achieve our goals.
So how you guys want to do this?
Well, you want to meet Miss G? Let's go on inside.
Absolutely. Let me just go get Junior.
Okay.
You know, so I can get my A game.
Okay.
All right. I got a job for you, buddy. My curiosity was, how does she deals with a person coming into her office with a hoodie on and a dog? So I just wanted to shock her. You know, I just wanted to just ambush and say, how do you deal with this? By the way, my name is Cesar. This is the most dangerous theme, a Mexican and a pit bull.
Yes.
When a Cesar was bringing in Junior, I was a bit worried. I knew Bo was going to react. I just didn't know how bad he was going to react.
Hi, we have a visitor.
Oh my God, see, Milana's here.
Bo, Bo. Bo, Bo. Bo.
Cesar has been called in for help by Tiffany and Sue Ellen, whose boss's dog, Bo, is disrupting the workplace.
Bo, Bo, Bo!
Okay, hold this.
Yes. Bo, Bo!
The one thing we shouldn't ever do... Here, do it to me. Yeah, watch out. Hey.
Bo!
That's all right, don't... When you pull back here, you keep the brain in that state.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm touching on the side or different. There you go. So we can snap the brain out of it.
It's funny, my freedomers have talked about calling Cesar for years. I just didn't think they'd actually do it. So when Cesar actually walked into my office, it was the sense of relief. Cesar was going to help make everything better.
This is what you want.
My name is Erin Gruel. My students call me Miss G. Freedom Riders Foundation is based off my work with my students, the Freedom Riders kids who did not have a voice and did not have a home, coming together in my original classroom and becoming a family. And everything we do is to give other teachers the opportunity to reach their students in the way that I did. We got Bo from an incredible event that the Freedom Rider Foundation was going to be the beneficiaries. We were invited to an event called Fight Night.
Gentlemen, take a good look at what we've got right here.
And they started walking around with this 8-week-old puppy. It was just beautiful.
$5,000, $7,000.
Obviously, this dog, for an ordinary teacher and a nonprofit, was out of our price range. And the woman in charge of Fight Night said, here, I bought them for you. I think he's the Brad Pitt of dogs. I just melt when I see this beautiful dog coming towards me. But Bo, unfortunately, has become like my students. He's developed some naughty quirks. He's very mischievous, and there's some sharp edges that need to be worked on.
To find the reason why Bo is acting out, Cesar has Sue Ellen re-enter the room with Junior, so he can observe how Bo reacts.
Hey, that's good. There you go, right. That's it.
Wow.
And then as soon as he relaxes, you have to relax with him. This is not an aggressive case. This is a dominant case. This is a dog that is in control of the environment. So therefore, he feels the need to protect what he feels is going to take over.
When I confronted Bob with Junior, he's starting to get protective. It took a little touch from me to let him know that I am in control. Therefore, he went into a calm, submissive state. Miss G is not providing leadership to Bo, which is ironic because she provides such a great leadership to her students.
Now that you can be a leader, obviously, you're leading a lot of kids, and not just easy kids. You're going after what I go after, you know what I mean? The toughest kids in the planet.
And I don't know why I can't take that same mentality that I do with these kids with my dog.
It's his good looks. His charm is taking over your common sense.
I am a sucker. Yeah.
Yes.
My goal for me today is very simple. It's to provide Ms. G with the right tools and training so she can be as good leader for Bo just as she is for her students.
What he represents for you, first and foremost, is affection. So leadership and then affection. I'm not saying not to give affection. I'm just saying that that's what you prioritize.
That was really this amazing part for me to watch a master in action. So I really immediately went from teacher mode immediately to student mode.
Cesar's first lesson for Miss G is to show her how to get Bo into her car, a task that's been impossible for her to do in the past.
Bo's missing out a lot. I can't take him to all the places we'd like to take him.
First, Cesar gauges how Bo reacts to the car.
This is not going to be the way, but this is just to see how he reacts to it. I see he melts. Oh. That's right. Yes, he melts. That's right.
He believes that the car is a bad place, so he needs to be taught that the car is a good place.
Cesar, I hope you know there's no way you can get him in there.
Cesar shows Miss G that she needs to make learning fun for her dog, the same way she makes learning fun for her students.
We're making it a little bit fun.
Okay.
A little bit like we're going towards the car, not in the car yet.
That's funny because I usually trick my students into learning, so you're tricking Bo into going on a trip.
Yeah, that's right. Instead of you going in the car and staying there, no, you're just going through the car. So we create an obstacle course, right? It's fun. Look, you're just gonna come out.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Right?
God.
Yeah. You owe me money, buddy.
Then, Cesar reminds Miss G the importance of providing students a little extra support.
That's a
good step. This tool we use provides support. So it's not all the way. It's the baby steps to get there. And then Bo said, yeah, with support, awesome. Let's go. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Hop. That was him.
When Cesar was able to get Bo into the truck, I immediately became that 16-year-old cheerleader again. All I needed was a pair of pom-poms.
Oh, my God.
I was so proud that he did it. It's the way I feel oftentimes when kids get it.
Your turn.
My turn. Okay, uh-oh.
Yeah.
Are we ready? When Cesar asked me to get Bo in the car, I was scared. I thought, I don't want to disappoint him. You know, we just had this great success. I'm jumping up and down like a cheerleader. And now it's my turn. Come on, Bo. Let's go.
Miss G has never been able to get her 140-pound lab, Bo, into her car.
Let's do it.
Ah, I see. He melts. That's right. Yes, he
melts.
That's right.
Cesar demonstrated that by making the car a fun exercise, Bo will jump in. Now, Cesar hands over the leash to see if Miss G can do it on her own.
Your turn.
My turn. Okay, my
Yeah.
Are we ready? Come on, Bo. Let's go. Let's
go.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Good boy. Oh, that's such a good boy. I'm like elated. Oh, my goodness.
Simple things, just to put a dog in the car, made it such a big deal. Everybody was so happy about it. It's like the dog won the gold medal in the Olympics. We made it entertaining, we made it fun, we made it the way he wanted to learn. They tell you how they want to learn.
As a teacher, I always adapt my lesson plans. Like, I teach to them, not at them.
Same thing.
Now that I can get Bo in the car, I can take him everywhere. It's going to change the way I work with kids. So to be able to walk into a room with all of these kids and have Bo bring them happiness and joy and to ground them and to center them changes everything.
You're amazing.
You are.
But Cesar's work with Bo is just getting started. Now he turns his attention to one of the biggest problems Miss G and the Freedom Riders have been having.
Bo, no.
Bo disrupting the office.
This is where we have our meetings, this is where we have lunch, and this is where some of the naughty behavior takes place. When Bo is disruptive, I usually pick him up and kick him out. But the problem is then he wants to be in here because this is everyone he wants to hang out with. So he starts barking and he tries to beat down the door.
Let's see.
Okay.
I'm all ears.
Come here, Bo.
He's already protesting.
He's already, exactly, Bo. And it usually takes about a minute and then he'll start barking and then he'll start trying to break down the door.
Bo interrupts the meetings because his owner is there, his people there, his excitement going on, and often food. So the key is to snap Bo from that excited state and change his conditioning so he associates meeting with the calm state. So that way he does not behave excited. Say squirrel.
Squirrel. Squirrel.
Hey.
To recondition Bo, Cesar has Miss G call out the word squirrel, a word that's always triggered his excitement in the past.
Say squirrel.
Squirrel.
Then he gets an immediate correction.
This is the sound that I use when I want to stop the brain. Say squirrel.
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 It takes the mind to a different state. Do it again. Squirrel.
Squirrel.
I'm going to overrule your conditioning.
Now when Bo hears the word squirrel.
Squirrel!
He's been reconditioned to not interrupt the meeting room. But will this hold up when Cesar tempts him with pizza? Bo's favorite food.
Stop him.
Say squirrel.
Squirrel. Squirrel!
Now you're adding.
Where's the squirrel? Oh my gosh.
So this is over conditioning by controlling instincts.
He reminded me, control your dog. Take those same lessons of having classroom management 101 and have classroom management 101 with your dog. He's perfect. He's not barking, he's not trying to come in, he's just sitting there. So now we can have a meeting. I don't need to send my dog away. I don't need to lock him outside. I don't need to put him at my home to make him behave. And so when Cesar taught us, when you can still have your dog be a part of this, but be on his best behavior, we're all the beneficiaries. Perfect.
Is this what it is?
Perfect.
Whatever you want is what he's gonna do.
As a final exercise, Cesar needs Miss G and Bo to master a simple walk. It's a dangerous situation for her to restrain a 140-pound Labrador from lashing out at other dogs and people.
I'm not as good of a walker as I should be,
yeah,
I can tell.
Yeah, well, I want to see you.
Because Bo is so strong, I do get very nervous when I'm walking and I see dogs coming towards me that have an aggressive nature, especially pit bulls and German shepherds, because I did fall. I mean, one time he dragged me through the alley, and another time I fell so hard I nearly broke my arm.
Look, he smelled
okay,
that already.
Okay, there's a dog.
You stay on your right,
okay,
on your left.
Nervous. I'm nervous.
Stay on your left.
Okay, I'm actually.
Keep him on a distance, guys.
Okay, I'm nervous.
Just keep him on a distance. This is dangerous.
I'm nervous.
Look, he smelled
okay,
that already.
Okay, there's a dog.
Cesar has worked with Miss G on leadership, and Bo has become an obedient student. But an unexpected encounter with a pit bull turns a simple walk into Miss G's nightmare.
Cesar, I'm nervous. I'm nervous.
Stay on your left.
Okay, I'm actually.
Keep him on a distance, guys.
Okay, I'm nervous.
Just keep him on a distance. This is dangerous.
I'm nervous.
There you go. And that's when,
okay.
But see, once, you did it right, eh?
I did it right.
That was really
okay.
Good. I was so proud of Miss G because she was able to control Bo and give him the perfect correction. The top of her foot snapped Bo out of aggression and sent him to a calm, submissive state. You got it, right? Yeah. So he's avoiding that. You got it. Oh, this is good. That's really dangerous. Here. My attention went out the window with Bo and Miss G. Hey, dude, can I do it? I just felt that I needed to go and address the situation with that pit that was in front of us. This dog, if he gets off, it's gonna be bad. It's just gonna be a lot of blood.
Cesar asks if he can work with the pit bull and help both dogs at the same time.
I'll be right there.
Okay.
I'm gonna connect. I don't know him.
Whew.
It's pretty bad. There you go, I got it. So you stay on this side. I'm gonna stay on this side. We're gonna take. It was definitely a big test for Miss G to walk Bo by herself when an aggressive pit bull is in front of her. Honestly, I have my hands full trying to control an aggressive, powerful dog, so she has to control Bo from lashing out without my help. Stay right here. Hey.
Come on, Bo. Come on, Bo. If I was timid and scared and had anxiety, Bo would have reacted. Look how calm Bo is. I was trying to exude confidence, and I had this air of, we're going to walk on by. And it worked. It worked. I'm so excited. Can I be excited now?
Yeah, of course. See the difference? When you come here and you put a leash here, and then you touch, you know, this part right here, what creates is that. It just snaps the brain out of it.
Pressure.
Yeah. Okay. But this way, when you were holding like this, yeah, you're telling him, we're going for a fight.
Okay.
Even though that's not your intention.
Yes.
I show the pit bull owners that their dog can be calm and not aggressive. I honestly hope that they learn a lesson so they can keep their dog from fighting in the future. Thanks, man. Thank you for letting me. That's what it's all about, you know, it's to help dogs, to help people.
I was terrified, but I didn't want Bo to know I was terrified.
I was terrified with you.
So it was good that he didn't pick up on either of our fears.
Let's go then.
Come on, Bo. Let's go back to the office.
I was terrified. I almost pooped in my pants.
So it really wasn't a lesson about Bo. And in the end, it was really about me, about being in control, about setting those rules for my own dog. Can I have a hug?
Oh, yeah. The girls love Miss G, and she has done so much for them. And I'm pretty sure they're very glad that they call me, because she deserves it. She deserves a little help. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
Cesar has surveillance cameras installed to monitor Miss G's work with Bo. Can she continue her success, or will Bo revert to dragging her to the ground and keep the Freedom Riders from achieving their goals? After the families have had ample time to work with their dogs, Cesar meets them at Joanne and Taki's new restaurant.
Hey, say hi to everybody.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Now Cesar has his first chance to review surveillance footage of the family's successes and failures behind closed doors.
You know what?
You learned that. Take it off.
No, I'm not doing that.
What is this? Like a strip this? Oh! You know what?
First, Cesar sits with Joanne and Takis. Cesar was originally called to help save Takis and Joanne's restaurant from the annoying barking moose.
Wow. Let me see you coming to the restaurant. I'm curious about it.
Now Takis tries to walk the dogs quietly through the restaurant without Caesar's help.
Look at you.
Stop.
Now your focus is on the dogs. It's a work in progress.
Takis is finally able to control the moose without upsetting his customers.
I did okay? I passed?
That's fantastic. That is incredible. That you actually took the advice.
Look, this is amazing.
This could never happen because no one could control these animals.
Right.
Truly amazing that Cesar was able to teach Takis and Takis was receptive to learn how to control his dogs. We're just very grateful.
Let's see the bedroom.
Joanne's biggest complaint was that the dog sleeping in bed with them was tearing apart their marriage, and Takis just didn't seem to care.
Oh, look at her.
She keeps sneaking back in.
But you give her affection.
Takis reverts back to his old ways by kissing the dog when he should be correcting her.
The mistake is you jump on the bed and then you give her a pet and then you give her a kiss. So she knows she's not going to give you a break.
But unlike earlier in their relationship, Takis sticks with it and uses his new command, you know what, and succeeds.
No, I'm going to have a lot of spoons.
Yeah, baby.
High five, man.
One more kiss.
Next, Cesar watches surveillance footage of Miss G working with Bo.
So this is the car. Oh, you're done here.
Yeah, I'm done.
He's tired.
He was tired.
Yeah.
It was a huge problem for Miss G to get her 140-pound lab Bo into her car. First, she tries to get him in through the trunk and fails.
I like that you try to do what I did with the boxes.
That's a good step.
Well, the only thing I can actually say that I can give you some suggestion, ask him just to put 2 feet on that, and then the rest is piece of cake. Let's go.
Then using what she learned from Cesar, she turns the car into a fun exercise, and Bo happily enters through the side door. Miss G had a terrifying experience when Bo confronted a pit bull. She had trouble restraining him and couldn't control his aggression. She practices what she learned from Cesar by bringing in a German Shepherd.
So this was a little scary. So one of the Freedom Riders came with a German Shepherd.
At first, Bo reacts, and Miss G puts too much tension on the leash.
You got the little leash. Oh, that's wrong. You don't want to do that.
Okay.
But after a quick correction...
See my little dance move?
Yeah.
She's able to get Beau into a calm, submissive state.
Oh, that's good.
Beau constantly interrupted meetings and kept the Freedom Riders from doing their job. Miss G uses what Cesar taught her to keep Beau outside of the meeting room happy and calm.
Wow, that's huge. See, laying down and staying and waiting. He's been told to do this, therefore he doesn't need to come out with, well, I'm bored. I want to wait for you. Just tell me where.
I realize, you know, once again, give him a boundary.
Yeah.
Here are the rules. Make him sit. Know that we weren't excluding him.
Yeah.
But also that there was a rule.
You did it. That's pretty much it.
Thank you.
Yeah, so absolutely. So, but you see the future, right? You see that it's going to be a beautiful ending.
Yeah. Having gone through the writing process with my kids, you do draft after draft after draft after draft. It's the same with me. I have to learn to continue to do those lessons with my dog again and again and again.
I am so happy that Ms. G can definitely do this and that we can actually take him out.
It's everything that she's ever wanted in a dog, and now she actually has that because of Cesar.
I'm like elated. Oh, my goodness.
I'm so grateful that you guys come into your life.
Give a hand to Cesar.
I got more from this experience that they got, and that's something that they don't know because they inspire me. They inspire me, and I'm part of that pack. I'm part of the pack of making a difference in the world. You know, some people do it with food, some people do it with writing, and myself, I train people.